conferred us with their benevolent presence. All the dignitaries to our luminaries in their chosen field, to our distinguished guests and new entrants, I welcome you all on behalf of SMS. Before we begin off with the proceedings of this first session, now I request my colleague Mr. Arun Kumar to present bouquet to Mr. Arun Kumar to show our deep sense of gratitude. Sir. Thank you very much. I hereby urge our director, sir, Professor P. N. Chow, to welcome our guests on behalf of SMS. Sir.
Chairperson of the Training and Placement Cell, Registrar of the Institution, Mr. Sanjay Gupta, my other academic and administrative colleagues, and my very dear students. This day is certainly a historic one, not only in the life of SMS family, but also for our new faces, being the students of the 17th batch. I, on behalf of the School of Management Sciences family, to which you have now become a member, I extend a warm welcome to all of you. Friends, orientation program, I would like to make similar request to you that in future also you try to accommodate their professional concerns. And I'm sure I shall be getting your blessings for all these students. You are very lucky to have the blessings of two important persons from the corporate world, Mr. Kumar and Mr. Pandey. And I'm sure your present PGDM peregrination would certainly be more and more successful. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, I will call...
That teacher and the student, learner and the trainer have the confluence in purpose. So they complement each other. To serve the ultimate objective of being learner-centered, we shall not hesitate in breaking away from tradition or convention and going on uncharted waters to devise, design and implement methods and all be free from ailments. Maybe. Thank you very much. Welcome.
Sanjay Saxena. Saxena, Associate Professor as well as PGDM Coordinator, to give a brief introduction of PGDM course to our new entrants. Sir. Management trainee in 1980, worked in personal department.
Honorable President Mr. G.S. Pandey, Prism Cements Limited, and Honorable Chief Guest Mr. Arun Kumar, Joint President HR HINDALCO Industries Limited, our Director Sir Prof. B. Inja, our Dean Academics Prof. J. P. Mishra, all our colleagues and dear students. According to current economic scenario and well predicted future economic trends in India for next 20 or 30 years, there would be huge requirement of human resource in the business field. And the major percentage of this requirement would be from management and information technology. Though there are thousands of colleges running PGDM and MBA programs, but still we are getting regular complaint from corporates that the kind of management professional they require, there is a huge gap between their requirement and what is being produced at management colleges. PGDM program at School of Management Sciences is different and highly successful in bridging this particular gap, what I have mentioned just now. This is only because we are constantly updating our curriculum, our courses, PGDM course, according to the current trends in the market. At regular interval, we are incorporating different subjects and new subjects and designing the right combination of traditional and latest management subjects. This year also we have introduced various courses, various subjects rather, on innovation, on selling dynamics, strategic marketing, business incubation, cross cultural management, current management practices in the market, so on. So these courses are definitely going to help you to develop the right kind of personality which is really required in the corporate world. No PGDM course can be considered as complete in all sense unless we give equal weightage to all the three facets of the course, like curricular activity, co-curricular activity and extracurricular activity. We have well objectively designed the different types of training programs on leadership, on motivational skills, on managerial skills, on communication, on emotional intelligence, so on and so forth, on even personality traits development. So these programs definitely will add a lot of knowledge, skills into your personality. Other than this, our students are getting well exposure in the working in the real work environment during their summer training programs in various companies, and your seniors are also, they are there in the summer training programs. And we also give you exposure to polish your talent and to develop your event management skills during our cultural, sports and literary events. So I can really assure you that we will not spare any efforts to transform yourself into a real corporate personality, but at the same time we expect that your 100% effort should be there to follow our instructions. If it is there, I am sure that we are going to make our PGDM program a grand success. So with these words, Congratulations to all of you joining PGDM program at School of Management Sciences, and I welcome you to School of Management Sciences. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sanjay sir. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Arun from 1980 to 1989. During this, founder faculty for Rorkela Institute of Management Studies and was also a regular faculty for RIMS, ICWA, NIT Rorkela for MCA and other academic institutions. Later on, he did his LLB, Deputy Chief Personnel Manager there. In 1995, he left SAIL and joined Tata Steel as Divisional Manager. In Tata Steel, he has been instrumental in applying many new HR interventions and creating benchmarks in the Indian coal industry in the area of productivity and introducing differential wage structure. Mr. Kumar has presented number of papers in various national and international conferences and seminars held at various levels from Australia to India. In 2008, he joined Aditya Birla Group's flagship company HINDALCO as VP HR and later promoted as HR head for Renukoot, Renusagar and Mines cluster of HINDALCO industries in the country by National Institute of Personal Management, the highest body in the country in the field of HR and personal management. Now, Mr. Kumar to deliver his lecture for the benefit of all of you.
Well friends, a very good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Thanks Meenakshi for a wonderful in today's context. And as gentlemen, the people sitting behind, so congratulations and compliments to all of you. Associate Professor and a friend of mine, Sanjay Saxena, Dr. Meenakshi. So even during that point in time, it was only few economies in the world, four economies in the world, that is Brazil, Russia, India and China. They kept the world economy floating. Otherwise it would have been in deep shit. The BRIC nations which controlled and still kept the economy floating, and at that point in time even the GDP of the world moved at a rate of plus 2%. It was because of these four economies. After that, the kind of changes which have happened,